The Jamaica Logistics Hub. It's a central plank in the country's growth strategy. It's also an important part of government's strategy for fiscal prudence and a credible economic program. The implementation of the Jamaica Logistics Hub will make the country the fourth node in the global logistics chain.
The Jamaica Logistics Hub will enhance the global trading system and as such represents a global asset.
But as important as that goal is, government is determined to see it realized in a way that is fiscally prudent. And if the government is really to achieve fiscal prudence, it must contain public expenditure and eliminate waste. The plan laid out for the Jamaica Logistics Hub supports this strategy, with the responsible minister reporting that the multi-million dollar project is almost self-funded. Minister Hilton says several investors are willing to fund the projects, basically easing the burden of the setup of the hub off the public books.
The same investors who developed the other three logistics hubs are now at the table with us, seeking to carve out individual mega projects and to acquire and upgrade existing assets through public-private partnership arrangements.
A Jamaica Logistics Hub master plan has started, with approximately $12 billion in funding from international agencies such as the World Bank and the Inter-American Development Bank. There is the necessary public expenditure put towards getting the hub off the ground, $50 million this financial year. The allocation is to purchase equipment and finance the provision of services and inputs. Even as government contains public expenditure, it must also find ways to stimulate the economy so that more revenues can come into the state coffers. That is a necessary ingredient for any credible economic program. Establishing the Jamaica Logistics Hub supports this. The hub will enable the country to produce more through its myriad of projects. The Caymanas Logistics Center, to be located close to the Portmore municipality, is part of the Logistics Hub initiative. This center, along with some 750,000 square feet of factory space in Nagohead, will increase production in the areas of telecommunications and manufacturing, creating goods and services which may be offered locally and globally. These projects and others will drive the economy by taking advantage of sea air connectivity opportunities and trade corridors, from production houses in the Asia-Pacific region to growing markets of more than 800 million people in the Americas.
The Jamaica Logistics Hub potentially represents US $9 billion of foreign direct investments, with the prospect of generating tens of thousands of jobs in a variety of fields during the construction and operational phases.
Divestment of select public assets is also a critical component of government's goal to achieve fiscal prudence and a credible economic program. The Norman Manley International Airport is one of several entities to be privatized for the successful development of the Jamaica Logistics Hub. Meanwhile, Professor Gordon Shirley has been appointed a member of an enterprise team charged with overseeing the divestment of the Kingston Container Terminal. This is to ensure that both entities are properly packaged and placed off the public books in a transparent manner.
We have issued requests for proposals and have received positive responses. We have begun to mobilize investment prospects, and we have been receiving serious interest from global port operators for the privatization of the port.
The Jamaica Logistics Hub is on track for its 2015 completion, and it's happening in a way that will support and adhere to government's strategic priority of achieving fiscal prudence and a credible economic program in financial year 2013-2014.